Hello and welcome to the Berg Cast. I'm your host, Brett Reed. And as you can tell, we are not audio only anymore. We have cameras and mics and stuff like that. But located in a college dorm room kind of makes it hard. So obviously the space isn't filled and there's a central mic and just like a secondary mic. So I'm going to work on it. But yeah, this is the setup we got for right now. And it's just better than audio only. So let's get to it. A little note card for the introduction because I can't memorize stuff that well. So, my name is Brett Reed. On this podcast, we interview D3 athletes here at Heidelberg University. And today, I unfortunately have the privilege to interview my girlfriend, Miss Emma Dean. Emma Dean, in high school, has earned first team all conference, first team all district honorable mention, and OCC special mention. In college, Emma has already achieved amazing accomplishments with OAC first team and OAC tournament team. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
No problem. It's nice having you on here. It's nice having Emma also because this is practically a test run, but also the main thing. So if it goes wrong, you're still going to see it.
Yep.
This is
unfortunately.
So it is nice having Emma on here because she is my girlfriend. So, you know, I can't embarrass myself too much, but and we'll make it cringy for you guys. So I guess we'll start it off with the first question.
Okay.
Where are you from?
I'm from Pickerington, Ohio.
Okay, if this is Columbus, give us a hand.
Okay,
This is Columbus.
This is Columbus.
Right.
Pickerington is just east, so okay. It's a little bit over here.
Alrighty. What's there to do in Pickerington? What's in Pickerington?
Not a lot, but it's a suburb, and we have a long strip, just like in Sandusky, of food. Lots of food.
Corn? There's a lot of corn out there.
There's a lot of corn.
I've only been there a couple times.
There's a lot of corn.
There's a lot of corn.
Corn and houses and food. That's all we have. And we go to drives to Walmart for fun.
Okay, so do you guys, when you hang out with your friends in, obviously I know all this stuff, guys, but I have to ask it for you guys to know. So when you hang out with your friends, do you guys hang around in Pickerington or you guys kind of just go to Columbus?
It depends on what we want to do. We go to Columbus if we want to go on like, we go on downtown drives a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So we like to see the city at night, but during the day, we go get food, or, I don't know, we like to go to Lancaster, which is just south down here, and there's, like, a big lookout over there. There's not a lot to do, so we kind of have to make up our own plans.
So, you have, I know you guys have an old Pickerington.
Yeah.
And new, is that all counted as Pickerington, or is it just?
Yeah, like, it's all Pickerington, and the part I live in is considered just, like, the newer part of Pickerington. Mm-hmm. And then there's the downtown part of Pickerington that has, like, the village vibe.
Yeah.
Like brick buildings and stuff like that, but, yeah.
All right, so with your Pickerington township, and you went to Pickerington North, what was your high school like?
So there's two high schools. There's Pickerington North, which is the one I went to, and there's Pickerington Central, which was, I don't want to say the better Pickerington, but they were better at sports. They're just an older school. But they're better at sports. They recruited and got more stuff. But my school, it was pretty big. Mm-hmm. It was a little bit bigger than Heidelberg. So I went from a really big high school
to a little bit smaller college.
But I like it a lot. I like it. So like the class sizes are the same size here at Heidelberg.
So do you think you know more people here than you did at high school?
Not yet. I feel like by senior year, I'll know like a lot of people, but I don't know. Since we're in one building, I knew more people in high school than here. So
okay. So at my school, I obviously knew everybody, and I don't know everyone here yet. I came from small. You came from bigger.
Yeah.
And it's always cool because you came from a D1 high school, and like Central D1.
Yeah, it's all D1.
Okay, so you have two D1 high schools, and you guys are both powerhouses. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
So that already makes it fun. So did you know people from Central Pickerington?
I did, but not as well because I grew up playing sports with the people from Central because we all kind of knew each other, but yeah, I didn't know everyone over there.
And would you say, out of Columbus, there's a bunch of Columbus high schools, would you say that North Pickerington ranks like on the top half or the bottom half of like best high schools?
I'd say district-wise, it's probably up there, top five or six.
And none of those high schools were private, right? Those are all public D1 schools.
Yeah, public.
D1 schools. Mm-hmm. Okay, so
there's a few private schools in there. But
You played softball in high school. We're very aware of that. So what got you interested in your sport?
What got me interested in softball? Well, my parents kind of, like, throughout my childhood put me in a bunch of different stuff. Mm-hmm. I did dance. I did I did volleyball in middle school, but I did volleyball in middle school, and softball just kind of stuck. I started playing t-ball, and okay. they just threw me in a sport because they wanted me to play a sport. And so I started t-ball, and then I moved up into, like, rec leagues, so, like, different age groups, like middle school. Mm. And then I went into travel softball in the summer, and that started when I was, like, 9 years old. Okay. So I've been playing travel softball in the summer since I was nine. And then I played school ball in high school.
And then kind of just took off from there. What yeah. would you say?
Yeah.
What would you say is your favorite sport you did besides softball?
Besides softball. I liked volleyball a lot. I did. I only played it for like 1 year, but I wasn't very good because I had never played
before.
Because
you were short? Because you're like 5'2". Anyway. Yeah, sure. So where would you say when you got interested in your sport, mm-hmm. would you say that you... I guess my question is, when you got interested in your sport, mm-hmm. like, did you pick it up right away, or did it, like, kind of take time to develop? Like oh, so, like, when I started cross country, I was like, cross country kind of sucks.
Yeah.
But then I started to love it the more I played it.
Like, my love for it, or yeah. my ability to play?
Like, the love for it.
The love for it. I would say after, I really started to, like it a lot in, like, middle school, because it was, mm-hmm. like, what I looked forward to.
Right.
And I still look forward to it, but... it was just, like, a leisure thing that I did.
Yeah.
So, like, I would play, like, during the week with my friends.
Right, right.
And then it kind of, when I started travel ball, when I was, like actual travel ball, mm-hmm. when I was, like, probably 13, that's when I, like, kind of fell in love with it.
So, would you say that when you were in, like, when you were 13 years old, that
probably
was, like...
probably in, like, 8th grade, yeah.
Was that your favorite, besides high school, mm-hmm. besides college, was that your favorite playing time
yes.
when you were, like, 13?
Yes.
So, was that AAU or whatever
it's
called?
Like, it's called PYA, Pickerington Youth.
Okay, I don't know what it's called over there. My bad.
Rec League.
I'm not Columbus. I don't have Columbus knowledge. Wording. Yeah, knowledge. There you go.
Okay.
So from Central Pickerington, from you know you're about an hour and a half away, 2 hours away. Mm-hmm. I don't know how directly far it is from Heidelberg, but that is you know Heidelberg's not a well-known school. So why did you choose Heidelberg?
I knew I wanted to play softball in college. That was the first thing. Like, when I was in high school, I was like, I want to play softball. Like, I'm going to do this. And I could never really see myself going to, like, OSU or OU or Cincinnati.
Was that because you're not smart? Or is it?
Yeah. Yeah. Good one. No, I just, like, didn't want to go to a big school. Like, I already don't know everyone here.
Right.
And I could not imagine going to a huge campus like that. So I... just was looking at smaller D3 schools. I looked at some D2 and, like, NAIA.
Mm.
But when I got on campus, I visited, like, a few other OAC schools. I visited, like, Muskingum and Otterbein, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to Heidelberg. I did an overnight here. And it was, like, really late in, like, my recruiting process. So it was, like, the beginning of senior year.
Okay.
And so I kind of needed to decide where I wanted to go. So it came down to 2 schools. And I visited here. And I loved it because the team was just super welcoming.
And
so
I was
here.
Like,
so I, yeah.
Yeah,
and
I was here. Yeah. Okay.
Anyway, so, so cheesy. So the coaches and the softball team just automatic check mark for me. And then obviously before that, I look at like their education program because I'm majoring mm-hmm. in education to be a teacher. And yeah, so it checked all the boxes.
And boom.
And I knew some people here already, so.
There you go.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, obviously, Heidelberg has a lot of, you know, we get a lot of different majors, yeah. but, you know, I feel like, just because this, like, is what I heard from you, is, like, mm-hmm. you know, education, they had your major, yeah. boom, you came here. There's a lot of people who don't come here because we don't have some of their majors, so,
yeah.
you know, it's always good that they have your major because, yeah. you know, this might have never, thankfully, whatever. Anyway, so now we are on, after a couple questions, we are on to our first segment. I have taken 3 of your teammates.
Okay.
I don't think any of these teammates know me, but I...
they probably do.
I threw them in here because they had pictures on the internet that I could steal, and I tried to make it as easy as I could, going on to the hardest. You can obviously see them, but you guys will also be able to see them as well. Sorry, the laptop just turned off. The laptop is behind Emma. And all right, so I guess we'll get started. There is... I can't give you any hints.
Okay.
I'm just telling you, it goes from easy to hard.
Okay.
You can take note, or, I mean... you can just look at it how you please, but...
okay.
All right, I had to lean in here for the first picture. There you go. I can't give you any hints.
That's fine. I think I know who this one is, honestly, right off the bat.
Okay.
It kind of...
Careful with your decisions here, because there are people that I didn't... Take your time.
I'll take my time.
Take your time. Who are we thinking? Who's in your brain right now?
That's a really good question. Okay, first off, Riley Cruz is in my brain first, because it kind of looks like her body type.
Right.
But I don't know if she wears her batting gloves in her back pocket. That's hard. Yeah. Okay.
Interesting. Is that your final answer?
No.
Okay.
It's either Riley Cruz or it kind of looks like...
I'm gonna need a final one. You don't get two options. Okay. You're gonna need a final here. Just because you're my girlfriend doesn't mean you get to cheat.
I'm gonna say Riley Cruz.
She cheats. What? Oh, okay. Riley Cruz. That is correct. That is Riley Cruz. Going on to the next one.
She wears her batting gloves in her pocket?
This is the next one.
What?
I try to make it harder by putting it in black and white for Emma.
Okay, actually, this one might be pretty easy because she's a slapper.
Yep, that is correct.
I don't know.
But do you know who that is?
I'm going to say Hannah.
That is Hannah Blazinski.
Yes, I know my team.
All right, this is the last one. I think this...
What?
I picked this because...
There's no way.
Their face was in it, and I really couldn't cut out any more than this, but I found this picture.
Okay.
And that's why it's hard, but you have to just kind of use context clues here. I mean, I can kind of help you. They have bracelets.
Yeah.
They have bracelets.
They're wearing a visor. Who wore a visor? Shelby didn't wear a visor.
And there is a visor.
They're wearing their arms like a knife. Okay.
You can tell. I mean, I can't. That is not really a... I don't know if this is a tip, but it looks like they're in the infield.
They're in the infield. They might be in the outfield coming in to dive. But Ray doesn't wear a visor. Okay. It's not Leah. It's not me.
It is. I will tell you that it is not you.
Because that's not my glove.
That is not you.
I'm going to say Riley Tomsic?
Final guess?
Yeah.
That is Ray Hammond.
That's Ray?
Yes.
She wears a visor?
This picture of Ray, I went to a couple games this year. She was an outfielder, and it was weird because she was an infielder. Thought I could throw you off. It looked like I did a little bit.
You did a little bit, but it looks like she was close to the grass, so I was like, that could be an
outfielder. All right, well, perfect. That worked out, so I'm going to go here. Okay, so... Moving on from Guess Who, we're doing another question, then go back into another segment. What was your biggest transition from high school to college, whether that being eating right, sleeping right, transitioning into like the college workouts? What was the biggest change? Even if those were all the things I just mentioned, you can even say that.
All of those, yeah, for sure. But I would honestly probably say my time management.
Time management?
Because in high school, I was one of those students that got good grades without studying a whole lot.
Mm-hmm.
I was in, like, the CCP classes, but I still didn't, like, have to put in a lot of work.
Right.
So, when I got to college, I'm not in the honors, like, house or anything, but I don't have, like, I didn't have time to do half my stuff I wanted to.
Right.
So, I guess I would say time management, yeah, for sure. Especially playing a college sport. On top of the harder classes.
Are your practices in college the same amount of length that they were in high school, or are they kind of way different?
They're way different, especially the setup. For high school, we'll just go like in season, springtime, because it differs. In springtime, the practices in college are a lot more intense.
Okay.
They're intense all year, but it's definitely a different setup. We do a lot of different things than I did in high school. High school, I kind of just showed up, and I didn't have to, like, eat right or drink more water than what I do now and stuff like that. So the intensity is a lot higher, and the practice time, especially in the winter and fall, we're about to start up. It's, like, 3 hours because we do lifting on top of infield, outfield, hitting, all that. So it's like everything all combined in like 3 hours. But they get shorter as the season goes on because we start games and we don't want to like wear ourselves out. But it's definitely different.
I think time management is a good answer across the board for any kind of sport. I think time management is a big transition whether you're in a sport, not a sport. Time management is just one of those things where you know, you get to college, you're on your own, you're not getting pushed to do, like, you have to do it. You have to go.
You have to learn how to do it.
You have to go to class. You have to go to the AT. You have to do this. You know,
And you have to choose to do it,
too. Right. Every single day, you know, I get a sliver of free time. I use that time. Mm-hmm. I mean, realistically, I want to use that time to sleep or play video games or whatever, but what I actually do is I go to the AT, I go to the library. I don't want to do it, but I have to do it because, you know, you got to pay the bill someday. Yeah. And you know that just as well as I know that. Yeah. So time management, you know, if you're listening to this and time management isn't really your thing, I mean, you can practice time management.
Yeah, with anything.
With anything. If you practice time management, your days just go by so much easier. I like that answer. I like that answer so much because I was actually I was talking about time management the other day with my coach, and it's just like one of those things where like I just heard it again, and it's like it makes me want to talk about it.
Yeah.
So time management is definitely key when coming to college or just in life in general. So
you'll have your free time here and there.
Exactly. And when you use your time management right and you use it the best of your ability, you will have free time if you use it. And then, because, like, think about it, I get my homework done in my free time, and then at night,
you'll have
instead of like having to do homework or stuff, like, also my free time, I can play video games and just relax for the night. So, great answer. I love that. We're gonna move on to another segment now. This is called Top Three. We've done it in the other ones, but again, it's in person, so it's a lot better. So I had Emma send me her favorite pictures, not my favorite pictures of her. Which I don't really have any favorite pictures of her because why would I? Anyway, let's go on to the top three. Let's explain these. We're going to deep dive into this. Here we go. We have a picture of you. It looks like you're catching a ball.
Yep.
Who are you playing this game? Do you remember? What do you recall from this game?
I don't remember who we're playing, but I think it was earlier in the season because I'm wearing long sleeves.
Okay.
So it was probably in like March or April. I don't really get many balls like that. I mean, we have a lot that kind of go over me, but it's really hard for infielders to field those.
And you're short, so.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. All right.
Anyway. Yeah, so I don't get very many of those that I actually catch because they're tough. Those are probably one of the hardest balls to catch that are in the air.
Yeah, because usually you get low runners, right?
Yeah, they're either line drives to me or on the ball or on ground balls or easy pop flies.
All righty. Next picture. You're swinging away.
Yeah.
And fun fact for everybody, you're left-handed.
I am.
How many left-handed people are on the team? Quick question.
I think this year we have like about eight.
Eight? So okay. That's actually a lot more than I thought.
Last year we only had three in the lineup.
Wow.
Which is more than normal.
Yeah. Okay. So lefty. All right. So explain this picture.
Okay. So I'm left-handed, but I field and do everything else right-handed. So it's kind of weird. I just picked up the bat like that. I don't know. It's cold again because I'm wearing long sleeves and it felt like a good hit. I think I remember that one actually being pretty good. So, it's good form. Good job.
That's a good form. All right. Oh, I didn't throw the. Oh, wait. Oh, there it is. Sorry. Slides got moved around, guys. My bad. I have difficulty. All right, here we go. This was one of my favorite pictures of you playing. I don't know why. I don't know if it's because, like, I can see your face or just because, like, you're in motion, but I really like this picture.
I think this is one of my favorites. I think it's definitely the top two.
Okay, so do you recall this memory?
It's warmer out. I'm pretty sure we were playing Muskingum, actually, I want to say. But I really don't remember from pictures.
That's all right. I mean, it's all right. I mean, you obviously, that is you.
I look like
obviously I'm canning it to first. There's no way you're throwing that to second.
I look like I'm dying because of my face, but I was probably trying to get
you're
it
You're definitely
really
throwing
fast.
That to first, right?
Yeah, yeah.
There's no way
I
that's
I was throwing that to first.
Okay, there was a safety.
I think I remember that being, like, a really quick girl. Like,
okay.
She was probably a slapper or something because I had to get it there pretty fast.
All righty. So that was that segment. Thank you for that. All right, so now we have two more questions, and then we have a nice last segment to finish off the thing, and then I'll have one more question. So what motivates you to do your sport? Like, if you, because like, I'll give you a quick example of mine.
Okay.
Mine is, I was not that good in high, I was average in high school. I was, you know, maybe even below average. I was a D3 runner. And what motivates me is I want to be better than the people that were better than me in high school.
Yeah.
So I always look at how they're doing. I'm like, okay, I'm getting one person at a time.
Yeah.
And that's what motivates me. I just cannot live with the fact that I
can't stand it.
Came to college and I need to be better than these people. Yeah. So that's what motivates me.
Okay.
Do you get motivated by like competition?
I used to. I think in high school I did because I knew the girls I was playing.
Right.
But I think now I'm more worried about myself and how I did in the past.
Okay.
Because in high school, in school ball specifically, I played a different position. I played outfield and I played center field. So I look at how I did there compared to where I am now.
Mm-hmm.
And I like to focus. I don't like to look at my stats as much anymore because I'll look at them.
Right.
But I don't like doing that because they could be good, they could be bad, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I think it's honestly just a self-discipline because I've had to learn a lot of self-discipline. And, like, my dad and my mom have been there with everything. And they came to every single game
Papa last and Mama year. Dean.
They came to every single game last year, so they're definitely a big motivator. And
so family.
Family.
Family,
yeah.
Just yourself.
Just, yeah.
Personal records and family. That's always a good one,
too. Yeah, and
too.
I have to keep good grades in order to stay playing.
Exactly.
So
D3 athletes, student athletes are the best ones, right?
Yes.
All right, so favorite sport memory here at Heidelberg. I just wanted to put an input because I'm the boyfriend, and I think my favorite sport memory is you hit a home run, and I wasn't there. I know, bad boyfriend. God, call me out. I was actually, she was far away. I don't know.
I was at John Carroll.
She was at John Carroll. I was doing homework. I actually was doing homework.
It was a few hours away.
And I remember I was on the live stream, and your dad, before the live stream, even showed me the play. Your dad texted me and was like, dude, Emma just freaking rocketed one over the freaking fence. I was like, no way, this is amazing.
Yeah.
Freshman home run.
That's probably my favorite memory.
God, I just stole the light. I'm sorry.
It's okay. You explained it well. That one is like the big one, obviously.
Let's explain it from your point of view.
Okay. So we're playing John Carroll, and I think that was a game we lost, unfortunately.
Okay.
But we split with them, but it ended up being a really good game and a good memory. I'm pretty sure that pitcher, she was doing pretty well, and I had been hitting really well off of her, and I had, like, I think I had a double and then a good single in there, and so I was, like, kind of due for a like, really, really good hit.
Okay.
And my dad, actually, afterwards, he was like, I called it.
I called it.
I was like, did you really? She was like, yeah, you were due for one. I was like, okay, whatever. Anyway, so I don't remember the count or anything because I don't really... It's all kind of a blur.
Right.
I remember hitting it, and it was really high. Like, super high, and typically you're like, oh, that's a pop fly.
Mm-hmm.
But it was really far. So
Right. Their
fence is really far. Ours is the farthest. I think ours is, like, 220, like, center. And I think theirs was, like, 210 or something like that, 209. I don't remember. 208, maybe. So theirs was pretty far. And so I was like, oh, there's no way that's going over. It might hit the fence, but it's not going over.
Right.
And then I just see the umpire going like this. I was like, what?
I remember
like,
your dad.
I was, like, freaking out because I was like, no way. And I ran super fast. So I had to get around and high-five my coach.
Your dad, I remember your dad said that you even, like, gapped the fence a little bit. Like, when it landed, he said it probably landed, like, 5 or 10
feet
over.
Yeah, I landed, like, pretty far over. I saw it go over, and I was like, did that just really
So that possibly could have went over our field.
I feel like that was either going to hit our fence or gone over our field. Yeah.
It still would have been impressive regardless.
That was, like, my biggest, like, favorite memory, I think.
Well, good job. Well, good job. I was proud of you. Everyone was proud of you that day. So.
Remember I texted you, I was like, guess what? You're like, yeah, your dad told me.
I was like, yeah, I know your dad already stole the spotlight. All right, guys. And now we have one final segment. This segment is from Soda Pops Downtown Sandusky. So shout out to Chad Kresser and Soda Pops in Downtown Sandusky for allowing us to try something from their store. If you want to check out more of it, you can check out that. I probably put a link here or here or wherever I put it. You know, check out Soda Pops. So today, Emma would not let me try the Carolina Reaper with her.
I would have cried. It would not have been fun for you guys to watch.
I thought it would have been funny. She did not think it would have been funny.
It
would have
been funny, but it would not have been
I thought it would have been funny because I just wanted to see her cry. Just
I
because.
Would have cried.
I thought it just would have been funny on camera, but I would not do that to my lovely girlfriend. So maybe not as tasteful, but really disgusting. We have these larvettes. I don't know how close I have to put this for you guys to see it. They're worms. They're Mexican spice worms. And again, this is from Soda Pops. So they have a bunch of wacky
crazy
candy of like scorpion suckers, Carolina Reapers, these. Then they have like actual old fashioned candy. It's a pretty awesome shop. And they gave us a few products to try. So we're going to try these. These look pretty
gross.
They look pretty gross. I can't say I've ever eaten a worm.
I haven't either.
But it says, you know, 10.1 calories per serving.
Healthy.
And there's only one serving per container. I don't know how I'm supposed to do this.
We just have like one. Does it smell good?
Oh, they're in a package. Wait.
Oh.
Oh, okay. So.
You're like, I can't even smell. Like, you're COVID.
All right. We have COVID. Can't smell anything. All right. Let's bust these babies open. I can't say I'm excited to try these, but.
I'm not, but I'm intrigued.
Definitely better than a Carolina
Reaper.
Carolina
Reaper. Does it smell bad?
I don't know. It just smells spicy.
Ew. Wow.
It just smells like...
I feel like it won't taste bad. It's going to be the texture that gets me.
There you go. Just get a handful in there. Just get a handful. Get a handful.
Okay.
Oh, oh!
That's good. Dang, I'm not eating
get,
all of that.
About to get your... All right.
I'm not eating all of that. Look it, guys. Can you even see that?
I gave her a lot. Oh, my God. Oh, they're moving. They're alive.
Stop.
No, I'm just kidding. All right.
I'm going to have one.
I'm going to try two. Just to...
These look... There's legs on them.
Ew. Oh, there are legs on there.
It's going to get stuck.
I don't know if you guys can see that, but there's legit, like, legs on that thing. Oh, my God.
I'm eating the smallest one. They're going to, like, taste like veggie
sticks. They're going to, like, be crunchy.
I'm scared.
All right, you ready?
Yeah, cheers.
All right, cheers. What the heck? Wait, I gotta try it. Oh, my God. You know what these taste like?
Tastes like taco seasoning.
It, yeah. I think it's just, like... I swear.
Why are you eating more?
I need to try it for the squad.
It tastes like taco seasoning, but the texture is foul.
Guys, they're airy. They're like...
Yeah, you bite into it and there's nothing else there.
It's like... There's like nothing there.
But there's legs on them, so you can taste
them. I mean, there's like really no taste, but there's a weird aftertaste.
Yeah.
But...
They don't taste bad.
They don't taste bad, but like...
The texture gets...
I kind of want to eat this whole handful just to like... See if I can really get a crunch. Alright, we're not... Alright, let's put it back in here.
Yeah.
Alright. I guess if I had to give that a scale,
I mean, make everybody else eat it.
I'm about to have worms in my room. Alright. Those were not awful. They're airy. They're very airy.
They weren't good, though. I wouldn't choose to get them again.
It's like,
they're good.
This is like, it's just taco seasoning with some, you know...
They're fun if you want to try. It's kind of like the Bean Boozled challenge. It's a fun...
Oh, that would have been fun, too.
That would have been fun.
I will get Emma to try a Carolina Reaper someday, but I will save that for someone. I will save that for someone else. I got, like, here. You want... Here. All right. So, final segment, final question. If you had any advice for the... Oh, my. That aftertaste just hit me so bad.
Drink water.
If you had any advice for the freshmen... Or maybe just, like, you know, people getting ready to come into college for softball, what advice would you give them?
For softball?
Mm-hmm.
Do your workouts. For sure, do your workouts because... So I did mine the summer before I came in, and I could not imagine not doing them.
Sorry. Can you?
I could not imagine not doing them. I hate you with that. I could not imagine not doing them coming in because if I didn't... do the lifts, all the sprints, the conditioning, I would not have been in shape. Because high school level workouts are completely different than college. Mm. Like, completely different. So definitely do your workouts. I would say get more sleep than what you did in high school. I know a lot of people like to stay up in high school.
Right.
I don't stay up that late.
She doesn't. Anymore. She really doesn't stay up late.
I stay up maybe until 12.
I can prove that.
I don't stay up
late. I think I might go to bed earlier than she does, but she still goes to bed super early.
Yeah, you make sure you get your 8 hours. I still get 8 hours because I sleep in a little bit longer than you do, but I don't go to bed very late.
I go to bed at like 10, but she'll go to bed like an hour after, which is like really good.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I mean, that's just how our class schedules kind of work too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So just get your workouts in. You hear that, freshman? Make sure you guys get your workouts in.
Mm-hmm.
Emma Dean, right here, specialist. I don't know where I was trying to go for it right there, but, you know.
It's okay.
Top-notch person. Oh, my. Put my laptop just said top-notch player right here. You know, in my heart. Maybe not in anyone else's, but in my heart, she's number one. All right.
Aww.
I don't know what else I had to say, but thank you again for coming on. It was actually nice interviewing you.
I liked it a lot. Thank you, Soda Pops.
As for you guys... I try, you know, it's hard kind of busting out edits and stuff like that, but thankfully on the weekends I have a lot of free time. If you guys want to see someone on here, comment down below. Unfortunately, I did want to put this out there. I did record a podcast with Drew Sims. I had a video with him. Unfortunately, that was audio only and it got corrupted because my laptop is cheeks, but... I think we're going to run that back in, like, actual, like, real life. So that will be fun. You guys have anybody else you think would be fun to be on here, even, like, coaches, comment down below. As long as they're Heidelberg University members, I would love to have them on here. Maybe not in my college dorm room, but maybe somewhere else. But thank you again, Emma Dean. Thank you, Soda Pops. Thank you guys for watching. Have a good one.
Bye.